All right, let's go.
I just did an early indoor.
Boat.
Shot.
Delta. Whoa.
I think we are fine.
Going Charlie Delta.
It's less about the nail order and more the healing. I was like, ooh.
Yeah.
A lot of that.
Moving.
Percent again.
Two fast.
I would like to disagree with that. Thank you.
facing Alpha. Bravo.
Second.
Charlie. On me.
I don't have MP.
I'll get him once a double turn.
I'm up.
Over 10 bellies up. Sorry.
Oh god, I'm
welcome
dead.
Here. Yeah, you guys are
rising under. Core.
You're gonna have to get thingy as well. I'm gonna finish it. Right.
But definitely.
I can't dress him. I'll just kill him if I do.
Yep, I'll
stay in the.
Careful of steering. Chain's going up. Shield's going down. You ready for the first arm play? Now.
Vote.
Did I get everyone the shield there? Nobody died. Right. Good job.
I'm in jail.
Shit.
Stack. Move. Move in. Stay. Move center.
My body! Help!
You need to move big, center with the kill through to me.
Big heals. Thank you.
Fuck, no.
But that wasn't there.
Just without your shields, I don't think we've.
Oh, shuffle. Forget the two. Okay. So I need to take this one here and then the one where Corbin just done. What did you say, Sierra? Something about something?
I saw someone running not center, so close to the ultimate. I think that was Kieran at the end. Or was it you?
No, I didn't move at all.
I need a couple of
I don't know, it was Corbin. It was Lalafell.
Sure.
That is
never run at the end too close to ultimate.
I'm back. So it finally arrived, and it was missing part of the order. My mom still tipped. I know. I was so shocked.
Yeah, Karin. Although what we have agreed on is that the light pillar person goes to the tank side and then looping around towards towards Garuda after she does her Kona Leiui, her
fan Leiui. I thought we said that they could go either way.
They can. Well, I
can.
Personally find Garuda the safer option.
Oh, I went the other way.
Question is, why would you go for a more dangerous option when Garuda is a much safer option?
I guess it depends on who has it and like jail uptime and stuff.
But
no one died to it.
I mean, I just have an easier time going left than I have going right.
As long as no one dies to it, then.
Yeah, I'm taking a lot more damage.
I'll smack you with a crit,
I didn't really notice there, probably. Shot.
Bravo.
moving Alpha Bravo. Moving.
One fast.
Not for self. Alpha.
Traitor.
Bravo. On me.
Is it me or the fucking, like, ABCD is like over bright on Titan phase?
I don't get to more to do with his arena.
I don't know, I did not notice anything. Except the fact that the pedal, light pedal, is a bit harder to see when it's on top of one of the remarks. provoke Vandalism.
Booked.
Thank you for calling that, by the way. Makes it so much easier.
Someone can cure it. Well, obviously, I'm trying to open the door. Scream. Away from C.
Stuck. Move back. Move in.
Oh shit.
Oh, he's damaged now.
Yeah, we're gonna die again without your shield.
Use all your medication that you've got, everyone.
Positions.
There is boom. Group southeast.
This is next one.
Damn.
Yeah, we are not in. Boss.
Did that go through super?
I don't think it did.
Okay, you need to pop the super before you get pushed.
Okay.
I also noted. What's up with the orbs? Is it something I have to do actively, or...?
You shouldn't have to, no.
What?
We only need one person actively popping orbs in the group. As long as you're in range to soak the damage, it's fine.
Well, I think the party needs to move slightly north.
The first
part is we are staying northeast, southeast, sorry. Get pushed away and automatically pop southeast set. The next goal is to pop the northeast set. Corbin is right. You just need to be in range of the explosion, and the explosion is not big, but you need to move a bit north to make sure you are in range, because if you stay where you get pushed away southeast, you won't be in range of the northeast.
Does it mean we are split into groups always for that already, or...?
We're not.
Because how many people do we need to soak? One,
all,
two...
All of you.
All of us.
All people.
Yes.
So, okay.
Except me. You guys are on one side of the bus, I'm on the other side. I'm soaking the other two orbs.
So you soaked the other two? Oh, okay.
Yes. Ben, you will have to...
No? No?
What? I don't know.
What were you about to say?
You will need to take the bus there, because he was moving with me.
Which bus there?
The bus. Take the bus, because he's moving
with me. Yeah.
So we're gonna be stacked on Benben, right?
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Okay.
Just I got a bit confused there. I actually forgot to LB1.
It wasn't available. It wasn't up. We didn't have LB1. That's what I was saying.
Okay, so I didn't know.
You might need to wait a bit. So me and Ash can top us off and shield us before the second orb.
It's weird because in the POVs that I've seen, like they got LB1 right after getting hit by the Ultima.
Was it because half the party was dead?
Probably. a difference, yeah. Killed people there, anyway? The landslide 2, again?
Yeah.
The landslide that killed people in.
How about feather in again, because I'm an idiot.
How much does that passage of arms actually help?
I think it's 15%. She just kicked me. If you don't want me to use it, I will stop using it. I don't mind.
I'm just wondering if you, maybe for yourself, is it better for you to DPS or do we need it?
We have no need for additional DPS. Like the damage doesn't even count for Ultima. Killing Barouda 2 seconds earlier won't make any difference. Maybe if I get to off tank Garuda and I get to AoE the plumes, I would consider that.
She stops smacking you so hard.
It'll screw with everyone's timings anyway if we did that. If we had you DPS more there.
Well, I still hope we get to try when we clear once or twice. Because even if I don't really care too much about having a good pass, I still would like to try my best in best conditions.
I'm just accepting the fact I'm probably gonna grade this fight, I don't even care. It's the clear that counts.
Yeah.
Like I've noticed, I'm pretty much half of Ash's damage right now, but it's because I'm focusing more on keeping everyone alive.
Yeah, same for me. I'm alpha. My dad's his damage.
Oops.
You're below my damage.
It does a lot.
Delta. Like, fact is, as it stands right now, damage doesn't matter.
Yep.
You know, so long as we're getting through it safely, I mean, this thing.
the second. Heck?
It's more into the wall.
Oh, okay. I was wondering about that then, because...
No, the eruption just didn't go out.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
And then suddenly three of them were there. Which is fun.
That happened to me earlier in suppression.
Just run and pray that you're doing it right.
Oh, fuck that up. Sorry.
It's fine, it's fine, it's fine.
No, it means you can't take the tether.
Yeah.
We only need two people to take the tether, so maybe you can...
No, like, he's going to die to Mezzohai in Ultima.
No, it must mean that we need another healer to... the other healer to take it, right?
Yeah, it's before Searin. So
it's fine, just let me sign. It'll be fine, right, if I sign?
No.
Say it again.
If we can get you up before Holman, I think it should be fine.
Yeah, it should be fine.
Holman's not till the end until after Annihilation anyway, so we should be good.
Also take his place and the healer with the debuff do the tether during the suppression part.
We could do.
Well, let's try to put you to my problem. So.
Well, great. I don't have set.
Ben's dead as well. Just wall it, because it's going to put cooldowns and everything. Yeah, in that scenario, Ben, it's probably best to just have Max sack. Like, I know a healer can take the other one during suppression, but it's best that they're with the group for heals. And I think if you go...
No, just if that happens, just suck, it's fine. There's no need overthinking stuff like that.
But apparently, if that happens, we should just like take the 2 minute twist, wipe, and we try again.
Yeah.
want to get all the fuck out of that hill. Take a shot every time I get my feather raid.
I don't have any alcohol in my apartment, so we could try that.
Alpha Bravo.
Moving Alpha Bravo.
Fast.
Facing Charlie. Alpha.
Third.
Bravo. On me.
Holy shit.
Provoke and Veliza. Yeah, A was safe, but it was between Infant and Ultima. I got a bit worried.
Away from Ultima, remember.
Provoked.
It's on Ash.
ready for scream. Chain strats up.
Make sure to stay in the back seat.
Shield
and
tags. You ready for arm's length? I think we're going to skip though.
Yeah, thanks. Nice.
I mean, we can arm's length the etheric boo if you want.
Yeah, I don't know, I used her cast already anyway.
Yeah.
Stuck. Move.
Straight back in.
Move.
Win.
Purge.
Move. Nice!
Great stuff. Positions?
Meditation.
The second bend then, right?
Oh, yeah, true, yeah.
Yep. Yep. Group on back. Big heals, Ash. Throughout the whole thing.
Oh no, it kills me.
Ah, so it hits through it?
Yeah.
But we'll need to have Ben go your side then as well.
Really? Whoa, I'm surprised.
Did we have Tank LB there?
I used Tank LB 1, yeah.
That did so much damage still through Tank LB.
So...
two people I think didn't get it, like me. On the second one.
Oh.
Because I was expecting Nex can get two.
Yeah. So what does this mean then? We need to rearrange a few cooldowns then?
Yeah. Most likely. I need to be with you for starters.
Yeah.
We will need to use a mild cooldown each, I believe. I suppose that Rampart and Sheltron for me, and Rampart and Afterstone for you.
If I use super on homing, is that alright?
Now that we know it doesn't work on the etheric boom, I guess, yeah.
Because then I'll have Nebula. Cool.
It's easier on me as well for homing. I don't need to worry about you as much.
Yeah.
I can help push to try and skip Vulcan.
Oh, sorry, I didn't see that Kirin. Okay.
Yeah, I think it was a couple of things. I think we took the second one a bit too quick. And I don't think we were full health.
Yeah, I was still like 3/4 of the way through my cast on the heal by the time he's popped the second one.
But now we've got to deal with healing tanks between them as well. So.
Heal yourself, hasn't it?
What I'll do is I will. Fuck, how are we gonna do this?
How are your stacks at that point?
I should have full stacks. If not, I can dissipate for full stacks. I will XCOG one of them. I'll try and get rid of deployed Adlor first. Right after Ultima, but it's gonna be tight because the time between Ultima and Etheric Boom going off is tiny.
Yeah, it's. I don't think you'll have much time at all.
Wait, hold on, let me see. Give me one
just
second.
Just have to be with them.
I was gonna ask someone.
I mean, realistically, you only need to put one shield on us for the second hit.
Yeah.
Because I'll do the majority of the healing on our side, so if you just throw, like, Lustrates and XCOG over the other side, instead of using any indoms or anything like that on our side.
I mean, the whole point of the way we did Annihilation is so we do have some breathing room between taking the first two off, so...
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll X-Cog one of them, and then I'll just roll whatever I've got at the pair of them. While you do whatever you can on our side, I guess.
Yeah. I can only suggest everyone on our side try stay pretty tight together, so Cure 3 can hit everyone.
Mm.
So we, as a group, have to take two orbs, right?
Yeah.
I mean, then that's easy. First orb is straight up, you get pushed into it. We move into second orb into range with Ben. Ben waits, obviously, then to stay.
We are not with Ben.
Yeah. Basically, what we were saying right before is that using Super Bolide on the orb doesn't work, so Nakazu cannot be alone. Apart from that, you are correct. The only thing is that you need to wait to be topped off before going into the second set of orb.
Okay, I mean, then Healer is gonna pop it, right? Because we're just gonna move into the range of it, but not popping it until everyone is popped off.
Yeah.
What I would suggest is, you know how we normally arm's length the first Vulcan? I can probably shield that one fairly easily, so long as I swift shield Ben. Which should, assuming we skip the second Vulcan, then use arm's length on Derek Boom, which should help with positioning. Which means, like, Sierra and, like, you and Nags can get full of time, you know, just max melee, and then only have like one person run out to pop the orbs. That means Ash can pretty much stand still and just heal the entire thing, as opposed to us having to heal and move, and like everyone has to run around and shit.
Oh.
Can like assign a pop, an orb popper on our side.
I mean, even if I do get knocked back, is there a reason I get knocked back southeast and I can't just stand in between the southeast and the northeast orbs?
Yeah, you could do.
If I get knocked back, I'm only getting knocked back the once, so I can still stand there and heal.
That's true, we could have a party stacking east, they get pushed east, and there is only the need of one popper, but him should be southeast to get pushed into the first orb, the first set, and then he's going northeast to pop the second one. And by having the rest of the party being east, you should be in range of the two set of orbs. What do you think? Do you see what I'm...
So long as the group adjusts and remembers that we need to be closer to the south side, because remember the tether on the south orbs is a lot shorter.
I mean, does it make...
The tether needs to get pushed into the set. The rest of the party, if they are above, directly east, they will be in range, so that should be fine.
Are you using
orbs big enough to hit? Are the orbs big enough to hit? Like, say we're at one and we get knocked to B,
yeah,
and the orb spawns here, are we in range to get hit by the orb explosion on B?
My point of view, the orb explosion is super big, so yes, if you are on B, you will get hit by the orb explosion that is on 3. But I could be wrong.
Does it make sense sacrificing a tank, maybe?
No.
It'll be very difficult to res them again. I fully expect to have to swift heal at that point.
You are Ram as a swift ready for that. It's not like the healers have to rest. We can have your Ram as a swift ready.
Just pick up the tank. Not back to click.
you're using LB 1 at that point, right?
And I did there, although I use it too early. I thought it would last too long.
Tanks can take one each solo with a cooldown.
One also, or tiny one. Sentinel or Rampart? I know you are correct, Nagazu. And in fact, like, we have one ultimate clearer in our FC, and he told us that he's doing 1-1-3-3 and he's popping every set
at the same time. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's perfectly doable. I'm just not sure what are the cooldowns you need to use to.
I'm gonna pop this in guides. Just have a look at it.
Are you suggesting that you still take two sets solo now?
No.
No. Okay.
Just have a look at that and see what you guys think to that. In guides.
And the music is so damn loud.
And yeah, the Aether orbs have just been confirmed that they do not, you cannot involve them.
What the hell happened now? I didn't even craft what happened.
So that's the thing that Ben was just talking about.
Did they just pop them all at the same time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'll have to change up Annihilation slightly, but I'm totally game to try. Does it need excessive mitigation though?
Annihilation doesn't need to save. That's true that we could change in and have it only one person to pop the four orbs because we don't need any extra time. But we could keep it like this, and personally I think we should
keep it.
Let's see what cooldown. They have Shake It Off. They don't have the LB1. Oh, do they survive?
No, they. I think they do.
No, they don't have the LB1.
Right.
They only have a deployed shield and Shake It Off. Or they have Divine Bell too. And for the tanks, the warrior doesn't seem to use anything. He's using Sentinel. I didn't see he's using Sentinel.
I mean, I'm game to try that with the LB just to be 100% safe.
So,
no. What are we trying? What does everyone else feel like they want to do?
I think changing anything in Annihilation at this point, when we're not even struggling with actually doing a Fairy Boom, like if we do running into problems, then it would be a good idea to try the Annihilation, but changing it without running into problems is stupid.
No, what I mean is, does this mean...
do Annihilation exactly the same, we're just changing up the Fairy Boom itself.
Okay, that would be fine.
Well, that's what I was talking about, like, I didn't realise that it made much of a difference.
Yeah, so what are we doing exactly?
Is everyone game to try the, like, popping all the orbs at once?
Okay, we need.
I mean, if it doesn't mean changing Annihilation, then sure, I don't.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
We need to make groups and decide where people will get pushed away.
Because overall, it means less healing and.
Yeah,
like,
we need
movement and everything. Yeah. We just need to quickly top off after Ultima and get mitigation going.
Okay, the four-way marks here. So imagine Ultima with the four-way marks. We need to split into four groups, 1-1-2-3, around Ultima. I would suggest to keep the west side to tank, or if you don't mind.
Yep, I agree.
No, that's okay, I'll take the northwest and we'll still take the southeast.
We should probably switch our healer and a ranged, one.
It don't matter, there is only one instance of damage, so, and everybody should collapse around the middle to share heals after, so, okay, I guess we can...
Well, do we have time to go middle and north?
Yeah, there is a lot of time. I will be pulling the boss north and he will change form. There is quite a bit of time to top everybody before the primal roulette. You should not worry about that.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, and just a reminder, I'm using super on the homing missile.
Yep.
Yeah, doing a defeat too.
That's good because it saves, like, beneath the blood sack.
So you could use it on ultimate.
Yeah.
The only thing that changed is that we will have less cooldown to mitigate during the primal roulette, especially the tanks.
I'm sure we can make do.
Yeah, I'm sure we can too.
As long as we still have at least tactician and troops are available for.
Yeah, we will.
Oh, wait, no. Available for the second one. That's not where we're going to lose tank anyway. So what are we using on the tank side for boom? Are we using tank LB? Are we using anything else?
A reprisal.
I'm not sure if Reprisal is working.
No. Oh, okay.
Not. I think we need
Veil.
Yeah, sure, I can use Veil. So, Succor, Veil. And that's it for Red Wave. Mitigation. Is that it?
Well, I'm going to try and deploy that more as well.
Oh, and VLB1, of
course. White Mage kind of sucks for mitigation at this level.
Yeah.
Implying it had mitigation at all, previously.
Comparing it's super strong.
Yeah, but before Shadowbug was with him, really.
Pure healer.
My mage just sucks.
Next
yeah, but it's
good.
Ever since they brought in Temperance as well, I don't have like a heal boost at lower levels.
Oh yeah. What was the name of
Divine Seal? It's really sad.
The Square Enix way. I'm gonna remove this ability and then give you it back a level cap with an extra thing on it.
Wait,
you didn't even get to attack that then, you just looked at it and exploded.
Moving Charlie Dalton.
Too fast.
facing Alpha. Alpha. Delta. On me.
So after the ultimate at the end of the friendly match, if you just sit and spam Q with 3 to top everyone off the boom, I'll try and fish for a crit.
During when, sorry?
The ultimate at the end of suppression, if you top everyone off with just spamming Q with 3 or something, I can try and fish for a crit pull.
Oh yeah, I'll heal everyone up. And then we get knocked back in our respective directions, I assume.
Yeah. Sorry, they let me. Nice kit. Thank you. at the thing.
Booked.
Screen. Nice. Airless hearing.
Remember, I'm using super.
Chains up. Right, I'm gonna shield. Dawn, arms length. Take your positions, kind of.
Since they are all gone.
Prizes.
Yeah,
well, that didn't go great.
Oh, okay.
I don't think we had enough mitigation.
Yeah.
I had fair illumination up for that with a sucker. Did you have Veil going?
I popped it too late, sorry. I panicked, used LB1, I went to forgot.
52 killed me.
Let's just go back to the way that we were originally going to do them.
Well, it only did 52k, have you seen my health?
49k.
Yeah.
I don't think
your heart of, is your heart of light at the start of suppression really necessary?
Not really, actually.
Do you want a heart of light etheric boom?
But I won't have it for the later phase.
We'll most do.
Okay. I'll take it out of there.
And if Paw moves his troubadour. Because in that clip, obviously they had Veils, but they actually had Devotion as well, the summoner thing, which he used to give damage mitigation as well. So. Let's throw Heart of Light and Troubadour at it as well. Plus the tank LB in Veil should be Gucci.
Yeah, I was fine on my side at least with just Nebula.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah, but don't suppression Troubadour. Like, don't Troubadour suppression, sorry.
Does that way feel better, though, if it went right?
Yeah,
I would rather have it that way.
Okay.
It's a lot quicker, and you just get through the mechanic quicker.
And, you just have to heal people only once, as opposed to that. You need to find the right amount of mitigation. Yeah.
out of curiosity, like, because I didn't really see, because I instantly died, Ben did use the Vacuum Explosion.
On the previous pool?
On the Etheric Boom, did you survive?
I messed up and I didn't pop Sentinel. I need to think about it a bit more. I'll try not to forget this specific one. I was super focused on doing VLB in time, VLB 1 in time, but I forgot the answers. Sorry. But Nebula and Sentinel have the same percentage of damage reduction. If my acid was on, I should be too.
Booked.
Chopped.
Too fast.
Facing Alpha. Charlie.
That's such a cool game mechanic. I still can't get over it.
I don't like it because I can't attack.
Bravo. On me.
Defender needs no LB defense, that do. He's only missing 20k.
I told you, you always get the crits when it matters. I mean,
when it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
When it matters, it doesn't pop.
I mean, it would have mattered if we were a bit slower and I took them on from distance. So. And then something. Only be safe and good. Perfect.
I'm southeast, I'm southwest, the Searing's still up.
Are we good?
Yeah, we can get skipped.
Still a pedals.
Move.
Straight back in, straight back.
Move back. Wait. Move.
Oh shit.
Silent fish for a bridge.
Okay, my pedals up.
Positions. Nice.
Ben Noth, Ben Noth.
No.
Everyone else Noth?
Watch which primals it is. Full heals.
You need vindication.
I actually don't have anything for this.
Wait. Move.
Oh, I got hit by Crimson Cyclone.
Scream, wait for the scream.
Go to North.
Shit.
Can I help you heal?
Enrage, no more heals. Pots and burn. Enrage, boys.
Burn
22%?
It!
Is that not a lot?
No, it's fine. Stay calm.
Reapply your dots before, like, at one gauge finishes filling.
I have no MP.
No, I couldn't get cheered off.
And I've been taken away, no.
No.
I have passed my top.
Oh, fuck, we see it.
This is too quick.
That was very quick.
Without those deaths during primals, we've got this.
Yeah.
Because this gauge won't be nearly half as full.
The Ifrit phase during the roulette is the hardest because it's somewhat tight, and I actually saw several groups popping sprint to dodge the Crimson Cyclone.
Yeah, that's north, probably a good idea.
So north, can you also not pull him so far north?
Yeah. Sorry, I had a hard time to finding my north.
I realized.
If we get that pattern again and it's tight and last, should we just stay where we are after the screen? Just converge back where we were, where the feathers drop, and then like sort of rotate around him for the weights instead of everyone like running north and stuff.
Sure.
It was a bit of a panic there.
So what you're saying, when we dodge for feathers, we should all dodge at the same way.
Yes.
Pretty much, yeah.
So which way are we dodging?
This way.
Clockwise. Which way is that?
Probably
this way.
Clockwise, yeah. So you look at Ultima and you just go clockwise.
Is that left or right?
That's left.
Fuck you guys, I'm going left.
I mean,
fine, we'll go
going
right.
Going left is clockwise.
Yeah, it is fine, it's fine.
We'll go counterclockwise then.
No, left is fine, it's fine.
No, if we go counterclockwise, it's consistent with Annihilation and shit. You know, right before Annihilation.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, that's why I was asking, why are we doing it?
Yeah. We'll go counterclockwise.
Yeah, and...
we've done it.
Going full counterclockwise, or we're going back to our previous position after the first one?
Just counterclockwise.
Okay, go around.
All the way around. So, yeah.
That's what I understood.
Oh my god, the adrenaline's going.
Oh, fuck, sorry. I fucked up.
Jeez.
To do about just lose a bit of
time. roughly when did potions come back up there? Did anyone catch that?
I used mine during the actual enrage. I'm not sure if it was earlier or not.
They'll probably be, well, they should come off just after that phase starts.
Yeah.
So at the beginning of the roulette, am I roulette?
Within the first primal at least.
And the cleaver for that.
Surely not. Great Peloton.
He always does it.
It's very useful. What?
He just run into the wall.
Why?
Mm-hmm.
I don't have Swift. Oh, he's got technical difficulties.
Folks.
Someone's should be finding
something.
Moving Alpha Bravo. Moving.
I think your chance rotation.
Yeah, I'm gonna see some eruptions off these little guys. Anyone else up front?
Okay. Facing Alpha. Delta.
5 minutes.
That could be really fucking awkward.
Yeah, Charlie, Charlie.
Nah,
we'll
be fine.
No, we're, six
we're gonna get kicked out, guys.
Reminds me of Shiva then. Oh.
Don't drink.
Right. On me.
Well, you guess you can come and see yourself, but do.
Very late, LB.
Yep.
Wow. What happened?
Oh. Interesting.
Huh?
Should we re-instance?
Yeah. Do you guys want to take 5?
Yeah, I could do it a drink.
Okay. What percent was that in rage pull?
20. Oh no, it was like.
It was 9
10.
Or something.
9%, I believe.
I can find out.
I'm pretty sure it was 9.
I will link it. Somebody in the Ashes chat made a link. Clip.
Yeah. Thank you, Moody, for the clip.
I put it in general. Yeah.
Oh, was Moody watching?
Yeah.
Yep.
Nice.
the raid wide AoE. It's just that since it's the primal doing the raid wide and Ultima keeps attacking and it has a damage buff, it just crushed me.
Okay, food up.
And make sure you have a inventory slot.
I'm ready.
Okay, do I have my stance up?
Keep pressing buttons and it's like not doing anything.
Focus.
One fast.
They can challenge.
Third.
Third.
You know when he says sons of man, murderers of my children, do you think he means his chicken nuggets?
Yes. That's exactly what he means.
Next skips the cutscenes.
I figured.
I need to kill the boss.
Yeah. Not bouncing. What happened before?
Thank you.
I got that suddenly enough.
Thor is the one to pop his hook. I mean, he cannot be too close from the tether since he's taking the tether.
Thor died to Super Cyclone.
Yeah, that's when you take the tip.
Might be my deploy when all khaki.
He died from 12,200 HP.
Possibly my deploy, like if Ben got autoed before the deploy went off, it would have like done nothing.
Thank you.
Hook.
Chat.
Delta.
Moving Charlie Delta. Moving.
Bravo. Charlie. On me. provoked and that is it.
Priest needs a lot of damage now.
Stuck.
You need to take it to the...
Move. Move back. Oh.
Now.
Oh well. At least we saw enraged. Like, that is...
Definitely better than that yesterday, yeah.
Yeah, it was a really good night. Really, really, really good night.
Still half an hour to go, isn't it?
Up to you. I don't mind another half hour.
I really can't.
We are raiding tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're still raiding tomorrow. And...
We're raiding tomorrow in the 2 hours time.
Oh yeah.
We'll get it tomorrow. And if not tomorrow, Sunday, definitely.
Sweet.
Paul was right. Like, the majority of our pools have been over pools, which is...
Alright, just make sure if you've got any questions about some things, just ask each other